All right, fellow gaming warriors. So, Chief Rocky here. Hey, we're kicking off another ship showdown. This is ship showdown number three. Right now, we got a treat for you. I got two frigates that I have designed. So, the far line that you guys seen in ship showdown two got renamed. The X Media left the server. I beefed it up for him. I renamed it for him. So it's now FF3. The fast frigate or fighting frigate, X Media, okay. And then there's another one that I worked on here that the Chisels is gonna pilot. And this one here, which has not made its way into the server yet, is a modified version of a 40K Warhammer 40K rendition frigate. And this one is called the Chaos Razor. It is a beast. Okay, it's a lot lighter than the X Media because it's a lot thinner. It's not as bulky in areas. It makes it a lot lighter, but the thing that this thing has over the X Media is it has
two heavy
quad 230s. So let's see what the damage can be done. Yeah, still here.
Gotcha.
Also, in the last recording,
just setting up these guns.
The last recording, I had it set to realistic. And for some reason it did not record the gunshots, so hopefully I fixed that. This one, so Black Pearl's kind of in the way, but here's the X Media. If you guys haven't seen it, I gotta redo the detail on the side. It's not FF1, but again, beefed it up a lot. Repositioned some of her turrets on the side here. I gave her heavier turrets, both pointing back, frontwards, and to the sides. And this server, this one is a beast as well. She is a beast. I mean, I would not get in her way. So, all right, let me know when you guys are ready. All right, guys. All right, so Chaos Razor and X Media facing off right now. Looks like Chaos Razor just fired some. Oh crap! Look at this. X Media turned around. She's backing up. Chaos Razor trying to get around. Are you having a hard time navigating her? Chisels.
Nah, it's alright. It's just, you know how it goes with frigates. You get a whole bunch of speed and then you just do past each other.
Yeah. There they come again, guys. A little lag. Come on. Yeah. Look at this. Chaos Razor is actually sleeker. But the X Media is a lot heavier. Oh, I saw that strike. The Chaos Razor lays it in. I don't see any apparent damage yet. Oh no, I see smoking. I see smoking on both.
I'm still good.
Yeah, both ships are still good. Oh yeah! Oh yeah! That was good right there. X Media knocked the Chaos Razor all over the place. Chaos Razor on heavy fire. Let's see what the X Media's got. One turret on fire. Oh, they rammed each other. It was hilarious. So the Chaos Razor is in some serious trouble here.
Come on away, Chris.
I don't think he can help it. I think his turrets are down. Or his thrusters.
Yeah, I can't tell. What's down, what's up.
Yeah, he's just floating through space. Wait, he's got his ion thrusters.
Yeah, I still got ion.
putting it in heavy. Chaos Rays are circling around, trying to use her big quad 260 or 230. Whoa, whole front end. The whole front end of the X-Media is gone. Dude, your shields even hold up?
I didn't see any shields.
Jeez.
Were they turned on?
With it being the secondary... I'm only getting 70 points. So it's not even 1, 2, 3. Shields aren't really showing.
So I'm out. I'm floating around in space.
All right, the winner goes to the Chaos Razor.
Yeah. Only because I got tired and rammed him, though.
She did fairly well.
He was actually immobilized. I was still flying.
Oh, no, he had ions. He had ions.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's funny because this ship is a lot lighter but more heavily armed. The X-Media is a lot heavier. A lot thicker with armor. And it has a shield. Yeah. Well, both of them are pretty messed up. Wow.
Bring them both back to center. I want to see.
The one you can't.
it's gone.
Yeah, it's floating away. We got where are we at right now? We're about 10K away from everything. Oh, you use the bridge seat? Wow.
Yeah.
Where are you jumping to?
A.
Oh, okay. He's bringing the Razor to A if you want to see what it looks like. Yeah, I see the Pearl. She's on her way.
Tell you what, a lot of the turrets on this thing held up.
Yeah, I put them in different and unique locations. I made sure I had some armor trying to block as much as I could.
Uh-huh. Yeah, let's say the hydrogens went down a little bit early, but this thing held up better than I thought it would.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, the front end took beefy amount of the damage.
Yeah, it did. Most of the decoys were on the front end anyways. It's not even targeting them. All right, let me clean everything up. Guys, so we got the Molnir, the BB1. So Chewy Bond's been working on this thing, and it is a planetary base eater. Okay, it eats bases and spits out its remains. This thing is a huge behemoth. Excuse me, I don't even really know what the tonnage is. It's upward of like 20 million kilograms. But him and believe we're going at it with the black
pearl. Ready when you are.
All right, let's go. Man, this thing moves like a damn snail, dude.
It's a brick.
Are your turrets on?
They probably weren't.
did you save a blueprint?
Yep, all my guns are off.
Alright, fellow gaming warriors, so we're starting off with another battle. It's the Mounir versus the Black Pearl. Mounir is a BB, okay?
I'm ready.
Bombardment battleship. I have to redesign my entire layout of my classification system because this thing's a behemoth. However, this thing is not meant for ship-to-ship battle, okay? It is meant just to eat bases. It eats bases for dinner, lunch, and breakfast, okay? It really does. Black Pearl is meant for ship-to-ship, so we're going to see how this pans out right now. Obviously, Mounir's got to keep his turrets facing downwards, facing towards the bad guy. Neither of your turrets are firing.
Guys are in the same faction.
Where was it firing before?
Beats me.
There you go. That wasn't a mistake. We're good. The other day.
I got fucked up.
Hey, he did the same thing to me the other day, man. I came in.
You done?
No, I'm not
done.
Yeah.
That stage where I probably should be done, but I can't remember.
This thing's like a fucking wall, dude. It's a movable wall. Take a look at the Black Pearl, guys. Well,
still, goddamn
it. Believe was not joking.
That's the best part. I am. I'm still sitting on my star.
He is fucked up.
Oh, I know.
Yeah, the Black Pearl's not faring too well. He took massive damage from that front-end assault. He's heading back in. He's leaking hydrogen, too. Pretty bad. He's heading back into the Mounir. Mounir's firing rockets. His belly rockets. So you can think of the Mounir as a modified version of the Thunderous Might. Just huge. A lot bigger. Black Pearl's moving out. She's come back in. Taking massive. Oh! Right through the center. Whew, that lagged out the server a little bit. Oh, wow. Wow. Wow!
Jeez.
Dude, you still mobile after that?
What the? I don't think either of you are mobile. Wait, no, he is.
Nah, he's still here.
Wait, no, no. I'm still mobile, motherfucker.
Man, wow. Hey, yeah, the two halves of your ships are still firing at him. Yeah, you still have a 230 battle turret firing at you.
Yeah, that was my last.
That is funny.
I removed the disablement.
Hey, you got room to put a shield generator on them now.
Yeah, I see that.
Well, you know what? I call this a tie, because when he split your ship in half, his ship ceased to work, too. Alright, fellow gaming warriors, so this one is going to be the Mjolnir.
So that blueprint I copied over included a whole bunch of cargo and uranium and ice and all that junk.
Yeah,
they got it.
So I'm actually at 16.7 million right now.
A big bitch.
All right. I'm at 11.9.
Also a big bitch. However, you're still outclassed, man. That's a battleship against your cruiser.
Yep.
Cruiser's got a lot of guns.
It does. It does. So does a battleship. But battleships are meant for bombardment. This thing's meant to ship the ship. So, see what happens.
All right.
All right, guys. Like I said.
See, I'll leave the faction here.
It's Liberator.
Be ready.
Liberator versus the Mjolnir. All right. The base eater versus the ship killer. All right. You had the Black Pearl, which
good
is the Maverick. The
all
one
right.
ship that you know could take out almost anything is the Black Pearl. Whether it's going to ram you or shoot you, the Black Pearl is going to take you out. So, all right, here we go. We're starting off. All right, so Liberator getting to acceleration speed. Looks like Chewie's going to try the same tactic as before. He's going to put the wall in front of him, launching missiles. There it goes. And the battle begins. Liberator turning into him. Liberator quickly maneuvered. How are we looking? How are we looking? Let me get on this side. Oh man, it's not looking good for either of them actually. Chisels is doing a little spin with the ring. Oh man, it's not looking good at all. Hey man.
Well.
Yeah.
Alrighty.
You took out... No, you didn't take out any of the ring. Okay, never mind. I think that ring is indestructible.
It's pretty good.
Could be immodest. Well, both ships still have power. And one only has a... 125mm gun left.
I had a couple front cannons left.
I think Mjolnir is going to try for a ram, but I don't think he has the speed to catch him.
Yeah.
Wow, dude. Wow, dude. Hell yeah, dude. That thing,
all that matters, right?
That thing was like a Native American, man. It just straight like filleted your head.
Yeah, I'm out of here.
Yeah, he's out. He's out.
That's a lot of guns.
Yeah, that Liberator's a beast, dude.
Yeah, I love it.
Alright, Gaming Warrior, so I offered Chisels a challenge. I pulled in three of my new modified ships modified from the other player. I'll put a link to the actual player that made this ship, and the actual name of the ship, and link the actual blueprint. But my version of that ship, the Chaos Razor, against one of his liberators. So three frigates versus one cruiser, and let's see how it goes. you ready?
All ready.
All right, let me jump in. Jump into Chaos Razor number one. All right, I'm on my way.
All righty.
Make sure my turrets run. Yeah, we're good.
Alright.
Alright, gaming warriors, so we're doing it. Coming at you again.
Gotcha.
Well, I was trying to shoot from my front end, but,
Yeah, that first swipe, I don't know what it was, but you took out three turrets on my ring.
Hope you see me.
Yep, I gotcha.
I saw my other fucking ships. That was you. Thank you. I'm out.
Tell you what, that ship freaking holds up.
It does, man. I'm actually surprised for as light as it is, too.
Yeah.
Alright, going for a 7-inch.
Gotcha.
If I knew where you were.
I'm back at B.
Back at
A, I'm sorry. Yeah, starting point A.
I gotcha. For some reason. I didn't even notice because I was off trying to fix a turret issue I was having.
Yeah, I know why. It's because I toggled them off whenever your last ship went down. That's my fault.
Did I do much damage?
You did a little bit, but it's my fault, so blame it on me.
I just want to see how many frigates you can, like, if you had to fight off a whole bunch of swarms of these type ships, how many would it take? I blew off my own front end.
Ah, jeez, there you go.
I was going too fast when I shot the missiles.
Yeah. On a space engineer's downfall.
Yeah, there's many of them. I'll tell you what, though, that new game I've been playing around with, Empyrean, it's actually really good,
yeah.
Dude.
Huh.
Yeah, I don't know if you've checked out any of the videos I've been posting, but it's pretty decent, dude.
Maybe I'll have to.
It's like, if space engineers actually had planets that had purposes, that's what it would be.
Huh.
Like you gotta hunt, you gotta go into the water and search for shit, like you had to use seaweed for biofuel to run your drills. Yeah, all the food, like spoils, so you gotta build a refrigerator.
Okay, that's interesting.
Yeah, and you could go into outer space and go, like, there's like, oh, I don't know, like 10 different planets? And some don't have any.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, some don't have any like vegetation at all, so you gotta build you can build ships just like you do in Space Engineers, but this one you actually have to have like a garden and shit. See if I could jump in the other cockpit while she's still floating. Yeah, I'm in the other cockpit.
Alrighty.
Oh, no, I'm not on the cockpit. I'm in the cockpit, but it's floating. Oh, shit. Yeah, it's done.
I gotcha, I'll just pull away from it.
Alright, what's your location?
I'm near point A, kinda. I'll be to your left. think I'm above you now.
Yep. Space debris hit me, just took out a turret.
That's pretty funny.
That is. It's like real life scenario here, dude.
Yeah, to get enough ships and it becomes a problem.
You sneaky devil.
What's that?
You're a sneaky devil?
I can't distinguish the sides of your ship. They're all symmetrical.
Oh, shit! I had you in my sights, too, dude. Single one of them.
Jeez.
Oh well. Yeah, just take it out, dude.
Alright. Coming around.
I'm pretty surprised these little devils put that much of a beating on you.
I think they're so like long that cannons target just have to get through so much.
Yeah, I think that's one of the reasons why I picked it. I was like, hey man, it's like it doesn't present a very big blocky target.
Right.
Oh, Warhammer Corvette, man.
And it looks cool.
You heretic! I'm gonna expel you from this universe!
Yeah, I saw the 80k Discord.
Oh yeah, they were going ham on that shit, dude.
Yeah.
Still wants to target your nose, dude. Oh, there went my quad 230.
Yeah.
What the hell?
Got,
my nose just broke off. What the hell? I'm spitting. Hey there, fellow gaming warrior. So, This is the end of the third Chips Showdown, and unfortunately, there's one more episode left of Space Engineers Season 1, and I'm closing it out. I'll be doing a full review of all of my ships, a fleet review. So stand by for that episode. Chief Rocky out.